Now, that is pretty much all the functionality of the oscillators on the ARP Odyssey. Except for one thing. One of the things that really set the Odyssey apart from the competition was the fact that you could play two notes at once. Yes, this is not a monosynth. This is what ARP called duophonic. How this works is that the keyboard can generate two voltages. If you hold down a single note, both voltages are the same. One voltage goes to oscillator 1, the other goes to oscillator 2, and you hear both VCOs playing together at whatever pitch they're set at. Could be unison, they could be an octave apart, they could be whatever interval you want, on a recognisable musical interval at all. But the moment that you hold down two keys, the voltages that the keyboard provide are different. So VCO1 and VCO2 are getting two different voltages. And they are, of course, voltage-controlled oscillators. The voltage determines the pitch of the oscillator. So your two oscillators give two different pitches. And let's give a demonstration of this. So I'll bring back up VCO1. So you can hear, as I bring it in, they're not perfectly in tune, so you get a slight thickening of the sound. If I play a second note, nothing happens because sync is still switched on, that's why. Here you go. And the oscillators aren't actually tuned to the same pitch. Right, start again. So, hold down a single note, and both oscillators are playing nearly the same pitch. Slight bit of beating going on. Play a second note, and magically you get two notes. Problem is that each note is only getting a single oscillator. If you hold down one note, that gets two oscillators, so the sound sort of gets thinner when you play two notes. And if you release the second note, both oscillators are suddenly playing the same pitch again, so the sound gets thicker. So it isn't without its drawbacks, because if your pleasing timbre is based on the oscillators slightly beating against each other, or, you know, the interval between them, if you have them set a fifth or an octave apart or whatever, that arrangement is destroyed the moment you start playing two notes. But you can sort of do cool things. The other drawback of this situation is that if your playing isn't terribly clean, you can end up accidentally triggering two notes when you meant to only play the synth monophonically. So if you're playing fast runs and you haven't quite released one note when you start playing the other one, you end up playing two notes at once. Now, some people say that's part of the appeal of the Odyssey sound, other people are not so keen on it. And that's the thing, there's no way of turning it on or off. It is duophonic all the time, unlike software emulations of it where you can have it completely monophonic or duophonic at the flick of a switch. It's possible to modify an Odyssey. I have read of people modifying it so that it's permanently monophonic, and apparently that's quite easy to do. It's also possible to modify it so that it has a switch, which does mean sort of cutting into the fascia or, you know, putting a switch somewhere unobtrusive. But the problem then is setting it up and calibrating it correctly so that it functions correctly, both monophonically and duophonically, and that is the challenge, apparently. There is an easy way around this for an Odyssey such as mine that has the control voltage inputs. And that is to control it from something that only sends a single control voltage, such as the monophonic ARP axe, or from a MIDI keyboard via a MIDI to CV converter. And this is great fun, because then you can start to play the Odyssey completely monophonically, and you can afford to be a bit more sloppy about your playing. An example might be if you were doing playing quickly like that, you can hear occasionally there are two notes triggering at the same time, and it means it's not quite as clean sounding and maybe loses some of its impact on some of the notes. But it's just another of those features of the Odyssey that is a bit of a double-edged sword. It's got its advantages, it's got its disadvantages. And whether it's an advantage or a disadvantage can depend on what you want in a synth. It can also depend on the context in which you're using it. But yeah, back in the day, that was sort of quite a big deal, being able to play two notes at once, when pretty much everything else was a monosynth, until you started getting into the divide-down stuff, the string synths and things that use that technology. But with those, you didn't have the same degree of control over them that you have with a voltage-controlled synth. I realised that there were a few points about the duophonic nature of the Odyssey that I had neglected to mention. You could say that the Odyssey is two-note polyphonic, because you can play two notes, two distinct pitches, at the same time. But I think this could be a bit debatable as to whether it really truly is two-note polyphonic. There's no doubting that you can play two notes at the same time, two distinct pitches. However, on most polyphonic synths, all the voices are identical. And that isn't really the case on the Odyssey. Yes, when you play two notes, those two voices are identical. Each one is a single oscillator. However, when you only play a single voice, that single voice is not identical to either of the two voices when you're playing it polyphonically. Because the two voices are a single oscillator each, but the moment you only play a single note, it reverts to being two oscillators for that single voice. Now, you could turn down one of the oscillators so that your single voice is only a single oscillator. But then you wouldn't be able to play two notes at once because one of the oscillators wouldn't sound. On most polyphonic synths, all the voices are equal. I mean, if you take the example of a two oscillator, say, six voice polyphonic synth, if you have both oscillators up and sounding, each voice will have two oscillators, whether you're playing six voices, three voices, two voices, or a single voice. Whereas the Odyssey, the single voice is different to the two voices. So is it really fully polyphonic? One thing that isn't in doubt is that the Odyssey is paraphonic, because the two voices share a single filter and amplifier. There isn't a separate filter and amplifier for each voice when you're playing two notes. They are not individually articulated voices. So that is paraphonic. But the polyphony, is it full polyphony or is it not? Duophonic sort of seems to be a thing in its own right, separate and distinct to true two-note polyphony. There is, of course, another synth that behaves in the same way, and that's the Moog Sub 37, which Moog describe as paraphonic, which it is, in the same way that the Odyssey is paraphonic, but all that does is really say that there is only a single filter and a single amplifier. It doesn't really speak to the number of voices, but the voices on the Sub 37 do work in exactly the same way as the Odyssey. There are two areas where the Odyssey's ability to play two notes at once yields some quite interesting results. One of these is when using ring modulation. Now, I'm going to be discussing ring mod later on, so I won't go into that now. The other area where playing two notes yields interesting results is when using oscillator sync. So I have a sync sound set up here. Doesn't sound very sync-like because I'm not sweeping VCO2. That sounds a bit more synth-like. If you hold down a single note and then play a second note as well, you then get some interesting changes to the timbre. So let's demonstrate. I'll hold down a C and then play some other notes above it. It's probably going to yield better results actually if I take the sweep off. Now, if I play that same arpeggio without holding down the C underneath it, it sounds different. Put that up 2 octaves. And you can do it the other way by holding down a note and then playing other notes underneath it. And if you just play the notes individually without holding one down, so you get different results depending on whether you play monophonically or duophonically. Let's try it another way. And if I play monophonically, duophonically, do it the other way. Duophonically. And that sounds a bit more like just doing a standard sync sweep on the sound. Let's drop it down. So there are some slightly unexpected results whilst using duophony with oscillator sync.